So this is a Venus flytrap. So they're actually very sensitive. This one is eating a fly.
Show where the fly is. Let's see.
It's right there. You can see its legs. But it got. And this is just how it works. So when they're wild, they actually catch their own. But this one is not wild. So and
you have to feed it.
Yeah, you have to feed it flies. But it didn't like the spider, so it didn't eat its skin. It just let go of it. But this one, it's really gonna need it because it's a fly. They're supposed to be eat flies, and this is how it works. So you feed it the fly, and then lick it. When it dies, a liquid comes in, breaks up pieces so it can fit through its throat, and it will give it nutrients so it can still live. But if you don't do things right, then that's bad because it will just start, it will cause it to live shortly. And the water, you can see this is in a bowl. If you didn't realize, there's water. You may guess for a little bit. I'll give you a couple of minutes.
What are we guessing? What kind of water it is? Okay, why don't you tell us?
It is, you can either use rainwater, but I use tilt.
Distilled water.
This is the bottle of it.
Distilled water. Why can't it use tap water?
Just can't because it doesn't get its nutrients from the water. So, and other plants, they get their nutrients from the water. So, but these ones don't. So, they can either use rainwater or distilled water. And there's not just this kind of bug-eating plant. There's this kind of, this is basically, there's these two kinds that are my favorite. The one that it has water in the middle and there's a hole. And then it has its leaves that drowns the ant. So an ant climbs onto its leaf. And then it's so slippery that it falls into the water and it eventually drowns. And I don't know the rest of the story. And these were just a couple of videos that helped me learn how it would stay alive. So this is Cole Byers, my mom's filming it, and that's it.